Until a few weeks ago, this was how it looked when Pope Francis gave his weekly audience in the Vatican. But on Wednesday, he used a video link to address the Roman Catholic faithful about the pandemic.
Today we pray for the deceased, for those who lost their lives because of the virus. In a special way, I'd like us to pray for the health of workers that are dead recently. They donated their lives to serve the sick people.
Coronavirus has altered some of the Catholic Church's ancient rituals, such as holding Lent and Easter services this year in empty churches. Other world religions are adopting similar measures to limit the coronavirus risk. At one of India's holiest shrines for the Sikh religion, there is more health-related activity than religious prayer going on, and fewer visitors to the Golden Temple of Amritsar.
In order to spread awareness about coronavirus, the Golden Temple has become a center. We have thermometers to check temperatures from a distance. All devotees coming here will be checked.
Buddhist temples across South Asia are also seeing a sharp decrease in the number of prayer goers. So has Islamist holiest mosque in Mecca, where the year-round smaller pilgrimage of Umrah has been suspended for the first time in more than 40 years. But the most drastic measure was the total closure of all mosques, not only in Saudi Arabia, but the Gulf region and most of the Muslim world. The Grand Mosque of Doha has also been shut down until further notice. No congregational prayers have been held here or anywhere else across the country for days. An unprecedented situation for a Muslim conservative community where observing the five daily prayers in mosques is seen as one of Islam's most fundamental rituals. The closure decision is sanctioned by a fatwa or ruling by Islamic scholars, citing the preservation of human life as a priority over religious duty. The decision is being hotly debated throughout the Muslim world. In Burkina Faso and other African countries where the virus has caused minimal impact so far, the keeping the mosques open argument still prevails. In Senegal, where a dozen or so infections have been registered, some major annual Sufi events have been suspended. Throughout modern history, the question has been debated over whether to resort to God or rely on science in the form of medicine and hygiene at times of great calamities. In the case of the existential threat of coronavirus, there seems to be a growing consensus that prayer and science should be combined for maximum effect. Mohamed Vall, Al Jazeera, Doha.